My dear students, here we are going to continue from page number 53, flowering plants. Okay, so as you know that flower is the most attractive part of a plant, right? And there are so many kind of plants are there of different colors, shapes and sizes. And you know about so many flowers, right? Different names like marigold, rose, sunflower, hibiscus. Okay, so many are there. Periwinkle, zinnia. So plants have a single flower, sometimes it have many flower, and some plants do not have any flower, like fern. You can see I have underlined here fern. Okay, I will attach the picture. You can see this fern we can see in in surrounding of us. So you can see they do not have any flower. Okay, but most of the flowers which produce seeds. Okay, means most of the plants they have flower, and from flower seed used to be produced, and from that seed another plants of its own kind used to grow. Okay, means from, as I told you about germination, so from that seed another new plant of same type can grow. Okay, so to produce seeds, flowers also help. Okay, and flowers of some plants can grow into fruits also. Fruits, vegetables, you can see like brinjal, chilies. So first of all you will see the flower, and from that flower we can see the fruit. Okay, so some fruits, vegetables that we all eat, that can be grown from flower. Okay, and all the fruits such as, you can see here so many examples are there: mangoes, cherries, apples, vegetables like pumpkin, pepper, brinjal, they all grow from flowers. And one more important thing is that flowers do not bloom at the same time. Okay, that means some flower used to bloom in spring, some in summer, some in winter. Okay, so that varies. Okay, so that is why it is said that they do not bloom at the same time, they bloom in different season. Now we will talk about parts of flower. So you can see here I have shown with the practical example. Here I have a hibiscus flower with me, and here I am going to explain you different parts of the flower. So why I am taking this hibiscus, because it's easy to explain, because here each and every part is clearly visible, so it will be easy for you to understand. So first of all, the basic parts of the flowers are petals. These are the petals, you can see here white color hibiscus I have taken. So these are the petals. And sepal, so this green part you can see, so this green part is called sepal. And there is a male and female part together in a flower. So the stamen and the pistil. So stamen is the male part of the flower, you can see this one closely. So that these are the male part of the flower, and here you can see yellow color dots, so they are called anther, and that line, this is called your filament. So these two are the male part of the flower, and that is called, together they are called stamen. That means stamen is the male part of the flower. And you can see this long tube like structure, right, this one. So this, and above you can see this one, okay, and inside this, okay, you will see ovary, and this long tube like structure is called style, and this are called stigma. You can see this, so these are called stigma. Okay, so these three are the together they are called pistil, and these are the female part of a flower. So I'm going to show you by dissecting this flower, each and every part, so that it will be easier for you to understand. Now you can see these are the petals which I have removed from this flower, and here you can see this part. Okay, so here it is ovary. Okay, inside this, if you break it or if you cut it, you will see here it's ovary, and this long tube like structure is called your style, and these are called stigma.
And here you can see this yellow color dots, they are called anther, and these lines are called your filament. So this portion is the male part of a flower, and including ovary, style and stigma, they are called together pistil, and these are the female part of a flower. Students, I have divided this so that you can see the ovary. So if you look closely, then I think it will be visible to you. So you can see this part, so that is ovary. Okay, you have to see it closely, this part. Okay, so that is called your ovary, this one. So students, in your home also, I'm sure that you can collect this flower easily, because it's hibiscus is very common flower. So you can also find out this, what are the different parts of a flower, and you can also practically you can see this, the parts of a flower. From this picture also you can get a clear idea about stamen, pistil, okay, the male part, the female part, okay. And as you know, as I have shown, the sepal part. So sepal, what they do, they used to protect the flower when it is bud, okay. So you can see when it is bud, like most of the parts are green, that means it is protected inside that, okay. And as I told you, stamen is the male part of the flower, which contain filament and anther, and that also contain pollen grains, okay. So in that video you can see that yellow color dusty particles are there, right? So in hibiscus you can also see practically, okay, in from your garden. So that is called pollen grain, okay. And the female part of the plant, that is pistil, that contains stigma, style and ovary, and in ovary they have ovules also, which helps in reproduction, okay. Now you can see here producing new plants. As I told you, from flower sheets used to be produced, and that is why flower is considered as the reproductive part, okay. Reproductive part means which helps in reproduction. Reproduction means it's the process of making new sheets, because from new sheets only the reproduction will be done, new plants can grow, right? So in flower, male and female part means together we have, right? So that is why how reproduction used to be done, the pollen, okay, the dust particle that I have already shown you. So the stamen is carried to the stigma, okay. From stamen, the stigma, it is used to be carried to the stigma. It can be carried out by wind, water or by the small insects also. And when this pollen used to be carried out to the reproductive part, the reproduction starts, okay. And pollen is, as I told you, here also it is written that pollen is a fine yellow dust which is carried by the wind, water or even small insects, okay. So that is called your pollen, pollination, that process, okay, that is called pollination. And when they reach to the reproductive parts, so then reproduction starts, okay. Now we will talk about flowers in everyday life. So as you know that for different purposes we use flower, right? So there are different flowers in our everyday life, in our gardens we have different flowers, colorful flowers, and we eat the flowers of the pumpkin, creeper, then cochineal tree, okay. So these are some plants, the flower we can eat, okay, by making fries or in as a vegetable also, like banana plant, okay, the flower of the banana plant. So that one is also very very much good for our health. From that we can get iron, okay. Then cauliflower is a set of flower, okay, flower buds. And and also not only we eat, but also they can use for making perfumes, soaps, lotion. You can get the smell also, right, students? When you buy something like that, like any soap or lotion or any perfume or incense stick, so in that you will get a sweet smelling, okay, smelling of flowers. So that may be rose, lavender or jasmine. So many flavors are there, okay. So they are made by the extractions of flowers, okay. And also from flowers, cooking oil also made, okay. So extract of flower are used for making cooking oil, okay. Then it is said that gulkand, okay, that means sweet mixture,
that is put into betel leaf. Betel leaf means, you know, pan. Okay, so gulkhan is used to be put into the betel leaf, and it is made from rose petal. Okay, so this gulkhan used to be made from rose petal. So you can see so many uses are there. Okay, so many drinks like sharbat, hai na? So they also made by the extract of flowers. Okay, you can get so many flavor for from that. Okay, we also use while cooking, we use rose water to bring a flavor. Okay, and also not for only this purposes, but also for making for decoration. Okay, we can say decoration like garland. Okay, in case of any occasion, in case of any kind of a festival, we used to means decorate with the help of flower. Okay, we can also make rangoli with it. And even for worshipping, now we used to offer flower while praying, right? So that is also a very good means also to gift someone. No, flowers is also a very good gesture of love, and as a token of love and friendship also we use. Suppose in our school also you may have seen, when chief guests used to come, we used to give them bouquet, right? So bouquet is containing flowers, so that is a good gesture from our school that we are respecting and we are giving you token of love. Okay, respect. Okay, friendship. So it can be anything. Okay, so for that also flowers are used. So I have told you so many reasons, so many purposes where we use flower. Now let's talk about flower motifs. Okay, that means floral motifs. Motifs means what? It is a design pattern on any kind of cloth or stone, marble, wood or metal. You can see one example also. Okay, so this is a floral motifs on marble. Okay, this is from Taj Mahal. Okay, so if you have ever visited, so you will see this kind of in full Taj Mahal there are so many beautiful floral motifs are there. Okay, so you can see a very good pattern on it and it looks very beautiful. Okay, so these are the designs, and flower patterns are mostly it's common. You can see in our bed covers, cushion covers, okay, curtains, sofa cloths, so many there, like for designing na, we used to use this. And flower motifs are commonly used on the basis of on the basic designing. Okay, it can be used in painting, inlay works, then jewelry, brassware. Okay, so many, like if you are buying a coffee cup, so in that also, like we can see so many you know, floral motifs are there. Okay, and as I told you about Taj Mahal, so as you know, that monument is what, made up of marble. Okay, and they have that have so many floral motifs. Okay, now a visit to the florist. As you know, florist means what? Who sell flowers. So they are called florists. So all big towns have a wholesale flower market that is called your mandi. Okay, you can see here mandi. So florist used to buy flower from mandi and they used to sell to the customers. Okay, that means from wholesale mandi they used to bring it, and then the retailer, okay, retailer used to sell it to the customer. Okay, buyers. So we can buy a variety of flowers in bunches, a stem, or in bouquet, as I told you already. So in case of bouquet also, different kind of flowers we can include. So that one also we can buy from florist. Okay, and the different arrangements are also there. So florists also keep flower petals for making rangoli designs. Okay, some flowers which they may not sell, or little bit of damage, so in that case they used to remove the petal and they used to keep it, and that one also sell as a those who want to make a rangoli, you know, different patterns, so for decoration purposes, so they can buy that from the florist. Okay, so you can see so many uses are there, right? So is not it interesting? You can also find out some more uses of flower. Suppose you can also relate it to your everyday life, like how and when and where you use it. Okay, so thank you students. In the next video we will discuss about different type of plants around us.